thanks for tuning in to Inside Taiwan. I'm Yvonne Netto. The food scare in Taiwan continues to widen as the latest round of investigations into companies that source their materials from Yusheng Chemical Company have extended as far as the local vendors at one of Taipei's major tourist destinations of Shilin Night Market. The Taipei City Government Department of Health now suspect one of the many food and beverage stores that Yusheng supplies, namely Jingguo Wang Food Company, to have in turn supplied plum and apple juices containing the contaminated clouding agents. The DOH has immediately launched a thorough investigation into all the food products supplied throughout the market.
Shilin Night Market is Taiwan's largest night market and a major tourist attraction. Last year, a Bureau of Tourism night market poll estimated that the market attracts 50,000 visitors per day on weekdays and 100,000 visitors per day on weekends. The Taipei City Department of Health is currently conducting random inspections of night market vendors and has found DEHP in one shaved ice and beverage vendor supplies. The vendor, which operates Shilin Night Market stall number 533, sourced sour plum juice and green apple juice from Jingguo Wang Food, which is a downstream company of Yusheng Chemical. DOH investigators also inspected Jingguo Wang's manufacturing plant on Tonghe Street and discovered a large batch of contaminated fruit juice. The DOH has launched a comprehensive investigation of Shilin Night Market and Beitou and will inspect other night markets in the second phase of its inspection.
The health scare worsens as an increasing number of food and beverage products are found to contain DEHP throughout Taiwan. As public concern grows, the Taiwan's Department of Health has joined efforts among 25 public hospitals, municipal and military hospitals in establishing free clinics, providing expert medical advice and consultation for those with concerns over certain products. The health authorities have announced that there is free consultation and registration at these hospitals until the end of June.
The registration counter at this hospital typically sees a lot of people. Even more are coming following the outbreak of DEHP in food products. In particular, parents worry their children have consumed this toxic chemical. In order to calm the public, the Department of Health launched free consultation clinics at Department of Health's 25 public hospitals throughout Taiwan, along with Taipei City Municipal Hospitals, Kaohsiung Municipal Hospital, Matsu's Lianzhang Hospital, and military hospitals. Before the end of June, citizens can get a free doctor consultation without having to pay registration fees. Still, doctors say that not everyone may need such a consultation. They say that small amounts of DEHP can easily be passed through urine. Furthermore, they warn many not to panic unless they have experienced long-term continuous consumption of products laced with this toxin.
In an effort to increase the competitive edge among Taiwan's domestic airports, three control yuan members conducted an inspection trip on the 25th at Shanghai to tour its Hongqiao and Pudong international airports. However, during an interpellation at the legislative yuan, the inspection trip was condemned by legislators who questioned the value of touring these airports, which are ranked below Taiwan's domestic airports on the global ranking. In response to questions over their trip on taxpayers' money, the control yuan members said they gained a better understanding of the room for improvements upon the return.
To make Taiwan's domestic airports more competitive, a delegation made up of control yuan members Chen Yongxiang, Hong Dexuan, and Zhao Changping, and personnel from the Ministry of Transportation and Communications and Taoyuan International Airport Corporation Limited traveled to Shanghai on the 25th. During the four-day trip, the group toured Hongqiao International Airport and Pudong International Airport. One legislator is saying that Hongqiao ranks below Taiwan's domestic airports in global rankings and that the members of the control yuan were clearly using taxpayer dollars to fund a vacation. In response, the control yuan released its trip report and noted that transportation between Hongqiao and Pudong became more convenient after both underwent expansions and that there are many areas from which Taiwan can learn. Furthermore, it carefully monitored expenses and the trip only cost 25,000 NT per person. In March 2009, several control yuan members also stirred controversy when Taiwan Railway paid for a two-day, one-night inspection trip to eastern Taiwan aboard its special cruise liner train.
Celebrating the merger between Taichung County and Taichung City, Romanian architect Stefan Storin won the Taiwan Tower conceptual design competition with a 300-meter tall skyscraper floating observatories that will become a new landmark in Taiwan. Located at the southern tip of Central Park, which is part of the former Taichung Shuinan Airport site, the unorthodox design was featured on the UK's Daily Mail. However, the budget for the project has been estimated at over 6.8 billion NT dollars, which has been sent to the City Council for approval, with a groundbreaking ceremony expected to take place on October 10th. However, many are pessimistic with the approval of the project and have deemed it as a mission impossible.
The Taiwan Tower has been inspired by trees in the shape of leaves. It uses 8 airship-type elevators using electromagnetic power to lift each floor and a total of 12 viewing platforms. They seem to be almost floating in the air like leaves. The whole building is powered by wind turbines and solar power, even potentially generating additional electricity. Taichung Mayor Jason Hu had planned this project to start on October 10th of this year. However, the budget for this project has yet to pass. Taiwan faces many natural disasters, such as earthquakes and typhoons, with many wondering if this design can withstand such a force. This was one reason the 6.8 billion NT dollar budget was held up. Taichung Deputy Mayor Xiao Jiaqi stressed that the completion of the world's first green energy tower would provide many benefits in the form of tourism. Standing at 390 meters, this tower will not only provide observation platforms, but also offices. It could also contain a museum. Council members derided the project for not being detailed and too rushed, saying it was simply cashing in on the ROC centenary celebrations. They also worried that it would be another stalled 10 billion NT dollar public construction, just like the failed Guggenheim project.
The price of mushrooms this year has soared drastically, priced at 1,150 NT per caddy for locally grown mushrooms, which is 250 NT dollars more than last year's market price. The cold spring this year has been said to be the culprit, decreasing the production of mushrooms by 20 to 30%, resulting in the price hike. However, mushroom farmers say that they have not benefited from the price increase since the intermediate suppliers have somehow profited from it.
Smelling is always one of the methods to tell the quality of the mushrooms. Still, domestic mushrooms are the best. Some consumers would travel far to Xinsha area for the locally grown mushrooms rather than mushrooms produced in China. Xinsha mushrooms account for 60% of Taiwan's total production volume of mushrooms. However, the particularly cold spring this year has caused the production of mushrooms to drop and therefore the price to surge. Even so, consumers still have to buy mushrooms to make rice dumplings for the coming Dragon Boat Festival. The production volume has dropped by around 20 to 30%, making the price of prime quality big mushrooms soar to 1,150 NT dollars per caddy, which is 250 NT dollars higher than last year. As for smaller mushrooms, even though the price surge is smaller, the price is still very expensive due to limited production volume. However, although the price is soaring, mushroom farmers don't really benefit from it. Farmers have opened up their farms for the public to know the fine quality of Taiwan's mushrooms. Taiwan has 3,000 tons of mushroom production per year, while Xinsha area accounts for nearly 60% of the total production. Comparing to Taiwan's expensive mushrooms, mushrooms from China are comparatively cheaper. Local mushroom farmers remind the public that Taiwanese mushrooms contain no preservatives, and its smell and colors are lighter than China's mushrooms. Consumers are advised to choose wisely to buy safe and fresh Taiwanese mushrooms.
Just like the variety of interesting and tasty dishes of Taiwanese cuisine, the glutinous rice dumplings enjoyed during the annual traditional Dragon Boat Festival also vary from north to south. The Hakka Cultural Association of Erlun Township in Yunlin County recently held a Hakka glutinous rice dumpling wrapping activity, allowing participants to enjoy this traditional culinary art form, while all proceeds went to the low-income families in central Taiwan. Let's go take a look at how the younger generation enjoyed learning to wrap the Hakka dumplings.
Nearly 50 women of all ages are wrapping glutinous rice dumplings for the Dragon Boat Festival. They wrap with practiced hands, and in no time there is a large pile of dumplings on the table. As part of its Dragon Boat Festival celebrations, Erlun Township's Hakka Culture Association sponsored a dumpling wrapping event to benefit low-income households. The association hopes to wrap at least 5,000 dumplings and says that the event also promotes local cuisine while teaching the younger generation how Hakka glutinous rice dumplings are made. While wrapping methods vary from region to region, the dumplings are all equally delicious and contribute to a festive atmosphere during the Dragon Boat Festival.